Good afternoon, students. Today I will deliver a lecture on respiratory system. Today's topic is atelectasis. Let us first see the definition of atelectasis. Atelectasis is closure or collapse of alveoli. Alveoli is a balloon-like structure. And it is filled with air. If alveoli collapses, that means there will be no gas exchange. It is described in relation to X-ray findings and clinical signs and symptoms. It can be acute or chronic. Let us see the pathophysiology of the disease. Atelectasis occurs due to reduced ventilation or any blockage that will obstruct the passage of air to and from alveoli. That means if there is obstruction in the airways, then air will not enter into the alveolus. Thus it reduces alveolar ventilation. After the trapped alveolar air, it is absorbed into the bloodstream and there is no additional air which enters into the alveoli because of blockage in the airways. The air which remains into the alveoli, it is absorbed into the bloodstream, and due to the lack of air, the alveoli will collapse. So the person will experience no gas exchange and it will manifest as dyspnea and central cyanosis. Let us see now the possible causes of atelectasis. The causes are: first, administration of general anesthesia, that is after general anesthesia the person may experience atelectasis due to shallow breathing, that means reduced amount of air will enter into the lungs. Also, because of shallow breathing, there is retained secretion, that means the airway will have more secretions and less amount of air will enter into the alveoli. Then after major abdominal surgery, what happens is the person will deliberately perform shallow breathing, and shallow breathing will ultimately cause retention of secretions. Third is unconscious patients. Unconscious patients will also have altered type of respiration and it can cause atelectasis. Then patients who are bedridden and debilitated, that means weak patients, that can also cause atelectasis because of weak respiratory function. Then person with respiratory disorders like COPD and restrictive lung disease. Also some patients with musculoskeletal disorders, that is paralysis of muscles which are helpful in respiration, or weakness of the muscles which are involved in respiration, that will also cause shallow breathing. Next is smoking. Next condition is pleural effusion, that is fluid collection into the pleural sac or pleural cavity, which will cause limited expansion of lungs. In hemothorax is blood accumulation into the pleural cavity. It will also cause limited expansion of lungs and limited ventilation. Pneumothorax, that means air enters into the pleural cavity and limited ventilation of the lung, that will also cause atelectasis. How to do the diagnosis? To diagnose atelectasis, we have to first take the history, that is history of any type of major surgery, unconsciousness, bedridden, etc. Then after that we are doing the physical examination. In physical examination, the main finding is diminished breath sounds. Breath sounds will not be heard while you are auscultating the chest. Then the person can have labored breathing or dyspnea. There is crackling sounds. In the X-ray, we can find out patchy areas or consolidated areas, that means the area which is not having any gas exchange. Then by pulse oximetry, we can find out low oxygen tension and hypoxemia, that means low oxygen tension in the arterial blood. Let us see now the management of atelectasis. How to manage patients with atelectasis? As I have already said that prevention is the main thing. Prevention of atelectasis is the best thing which we can adopt. How to prevent? First, we have to teach the patients deep breathing cuffing exercise. Change the position of patients who are bedridden every 2 hours. Incentive spirometry can be taught for postoperative patients. In case of retained secretions or copious secretion, nebulization can be done. Chest physiotherapy will also help in removing the secretions. Then frequent suctioning of cuff can also be done to remove the secretion. Early ambulation, it is a very effective method to reduce the chance of atelectasis. Early ambulation means early movement after surgery, especially for patient who have undergone surgery. We have to encourage the patient to walk as early as possible. After that, minimum use of opioid analgesic or judicious use of opioid analgesic, because opioids, what it does, it will reduce the respiratory activity. That means the person can experience bradypnea, shallow breathing in case of when the patient gets opioid analgesic. Then thoracentesis can be done in case of pleural effusion. Bronchoscopy can be done in case of any foreign substances or any amount of secretions which is not been removed by suction. Management will also include mechanical ventilation in case of impending respiratory failure. When prevention is not possible, then you can use the ventilator. The nursing management of a patient with atelectasis. Nursing management is huge. We have a very huge responsibility in the prevention part. That means how to prevent atelectasis from occurring. So all the preventive measures has to be adopted, which I have already discussed. And in case the patient is on mechanical ventilator, we have to closely monitor all the various type of parameters or the vital signs to prevent any type of complications. So this is all about the topic atelectasis. If you have any doubt, you are free to ask. Also, you supplement this lecture with reading, and you have to follow one standard textbook for detailed reading of this particular topic. Thank you.